Mrs. Rhodes. Gee, you're looking haggard. Isn't this nice? The birds are singing. The whole neighborhood smells of bacon. And you know, everybody says that the clouds look especially fluffy. Well, I'm moving on up to the east side in the sky. We're moving on up.
Moving on up
to the east side.
Moving on up.
We finally got a piece of the pie. Yeah. Oh, no, Mom. This is my Valentine's Day outfit. See, all the guys are down at the mall. Hi, Mom. Oh, Bud, it's Sun. Well, Mom, I've got all my cards in this bag. Get ready for my real date.
Did you write that, Kel? Just say yes or no.
No.
Oh, come on, Kel, really, I know you did.
Okay, yeah, I did.
Oh, no, you didn't.
Really, Kel? Bud, I don't know why you're dressed like that. If you don't think you really have a date, why did you pass up a chance to go to the game? Oh, by the way, Dad, Mom's upstairs cursing you. I'm late, I gotta go. I'd be getting ready if I were you, Bud. Teacher through a window. But still, there's something I like about him.
We can use that money to buy one of those soft toilet seats and make every day a vacation. And the best part is, we're taking the family car.
Yeah, we did that.
Is there any actual food here? Or do I just stand by a bug light with my mouth open? Oh, Mom! Well, he promised to give me another driving lesson today.
Quiz you, Kel?
Sure.
Where were you last night?
car meet.
That's my girl!
Las Vegas, the city that never rests, the city of Viva, the city of lust, greed, and excess. My city, Lost Bud.
Yeah, well, over the Rockies, you were Mr. Hold Me, Daddy, we're gonna fly into the sun.
Now, kids, you know where we came? One, to get my TV, two, to get my $5,000 back, and, what was that?
See that fat lady over there? I'm sorry, Kel. You let your mind go blank, and then what? Kelly, marry me. Damn the law.
Seven.
This month, we're doing the ones personally delivered by the sheriff.
Don't forget now. I said I will. What do I look like, an idiot?
The hell you mean storage bin? Nobody told me about a storage bin. What could we possibly put in a storage bin?
And I'll take this.
How much for this wagon wheel?
25 cents.
That's ridiculous. I'll give you 50 cents.
No, my daddy says 25.
And I'd like this, and this, and this.
Hey, Dad, I got a live one here. She'll buy anything.
Give up and become Sanford and Son.
A job. Me. God did not create this package to work. Bud, I want this. Thanks, Bud. You really think I have a chance? You're with those other girls are prettier than I am.
Not a. Hold my calls.
Honey, do you think there's a place?
down from here? Bud, what do you think? This look good for my graduation picture?
I don't know, Kel. If you really want people to remember you, you might want to try this.
Kiss me with a hammer. Okay, who ordered the coffee?
I did.
Okay. Look, I made it cloudy way up in the pointy states. Well, thank you, Mrs. Rhodes. That was the third guy this week that I was truly in love with.
See, I have this, well, this problem. I mean, it's real.
Well, and then there's this business with your wedding ring. I mean, a pretty woman can get away with it, but... Fine, then we'll just get you a catpole.
I feel renewed. I'm ready to fly. Oh.
I know that means something bad.
That was great. She would... Kel, I can't remember a thing.
Oh, wow. You know, they say if a man can't remember anything, it's the best it'll ever be.
That's exactly what it was. Too much of a good thing.
I think something's rotten in the state of Denver, Mom. Christmas without presents is like Thanksgiving without pizza. I'm home from college.
College? She flunked lunch in high school.
Well, yeah. I passed math. French, too, and I'm not even taking that. They only use it to pull us up, to pull us down. You know, one day I'm just gonna say, hey, use your own hair to wax that car.
Pushing the car. Doesn't it work? Look pretty boring.
Hey, Dad. Saw you pushing the old car. Me and my friends never thought you'd make it up the hill.
Thanks, Dad. Oh, and push it fast so we look cool, okay? Car, get out of the car. You know, you're starting to sound like one of my dates. They promised me ice cream, too, but they never give me any.
Don't get us wrong.
I can't wait to have kids so I can make them suffer.
Oh, when they ask who their dad is, you can play Wheel of Father.
Well, I guess you're out of here then, huh, Mom? Bud, you're the woman of the house now. And your underwear's under the table.
Correct way to pick something up is to bend from the knees.
What a shame. A body like that and not a brain in his head.
Mom kills some guy and we have to suffer.
Yeah, why didn't we have to use forks when Aunt Pearlie killed Uncle Dave? Go kiss your Stridex pad.
Now, wait a minute. Is everybody gonna be home today?
Not me. I've gotta get some money for tickets to the Oozing Meat concert tomorrow. So I've gotta roll up my sleeves and work really hard to get this thing. Well, that wasn't so bad.
Yeah, thank God we didn't need tetanus shots.
Oh, I hate that little pin. Ooh. Reminds me I'm late for my date.
I believe her name is pronounced Yvette.
I was pronouncing it in English.
Oh, man. What a...
A real girl. Not just a boy trapped in a pimple's body. It'll be great. I can teach her about American guys, and she can help me by carrying my school supplies. You know, like my music, my Walkman, my overnight bag. Oh, you mean like when I get an idea?
Kelly!
Oh, you are so popular.
Yeah, well, I'm kind of like the Beatles of the 20th century. Sure, I have no life. I'll get it. Maybe it's someone from the future geeks of America wanting me to join. Yep, it's the founders. I mean, try. So, I finally started dating a nerd. Nerd.
Geek girl.
Never. Oh, come on, bud. Just pretend that it's a normal Saturday night. Let's see. Who should I make the lucky recipient of what's behind bikini number one?
What's wrong?
I feel sad every time I see an empty spot behind a rock. Would you join me? If they can't swim, why do they come to the beach?
Gee, alone, Kel.
Yeah. Neither of us did any good today. I guess the bet's off.
Yeah. What subjects do you need help in?
I don't know. What classes am I taking? Bud's really been helping me. We've been studying history. For instance, did you know that Thomas Jefferson's wife was black? Doorbell! Guess what? One of your guest cars sprung a leak, and, young Bud and I thought that it was a fire hazard. So luckily, we happened along with these. Can Buck have the coat upstairs and I can't have boys in my room? Now that Tony's worm food, I can get out of these funeral clothes. Oh, Dad, you know how I've been bothering you about a sports car? Well, forget it. I want a hearse. And when it does, you'll be glad we have that hearse.
Why don't you just go to Kelly's guy, Mr. Albino?
Or you could always go to Bud.
Would you like me to take your check now, sir?
No.
Hi, Mom. How's it going? Oh, fine.
Taking Kelly shopping.
Oh, look, Mom. Hey, Mom, you want to buy Bud a jacket? Oh, not to me. Well, good night. There's this girl who looks just like me who got into a peck of trouble today. So if the principal calls and... Hey, what say we unplug the phones and play Yahtzee?
Dad, I couldn't find your belt, but I figured we'd tie her down with this...
Well, you're gonna have to take a number. They're already punishing me at school. Principal Wicker's been out to get me ever since I stole her stupid husband.
Around me, I get a fever that's so hard to bear. You.
cramps in my leg right here. Do you think you could get that out?
Well, it may take some time, but I'll do what I can.
Hi, Dad.
It's Kelly, the soup girl.
Hey, Kel, where's Matt?
Damn it!
Daddy alone, Mom. He works hard for his money. Dad? Could I have $100 for a python? I need one for the school talent show.
Mary, you'd think she'd learn. I mean, every year she turns on the oldie station, cranks it up real loud, and dances the dances of our forefathers.
But if I ever get that old and act like that, would you please shoot me?
Why wait?
Hi, Mom.
Hi, Dad.
Kids, why didn't you tell me it was your mother's birthday? I wouldn't have come home.
Hey, Mom, my clothes, they smell clean.
And my sweater, you can tell what color it is.
Yeah, look, you got those grass stains off the back.
Thank you, Mrs. Rhodes.
Precious.